Imagine receiving a free gadget for your smart home, a light switch, a security camera, perhaps even a robot vacuum your house. You think it's a great deal, but what if that device is actually part of a countrywide spying network? That's not science fiction. It's how harmless-seeming Chinese-made smart devices are already infiltrating Western homes. Welcome back to Hacking Matters, your destination for cyber education and best practices. I'm Carsten. You know, we talk a lot about protecting corporate networks, but what about the digital frontier in our own living rooms? Smart devices are convenient, but they bring often overlooked new security risks. Today, we're diving into how these cheap, ubiquitous gadgets can become digital spies and what you can do about it. The smart gadget spying risk isn't just theoretical. Two researchers revealed groundbreaking research last year at the NoHatCon, Adam Schaal and Matt Virus. The researchers discovered what they coined the product review cabal, which introduces backdoors into our homes under the pretense of soliciting product reviews. The researchers, driven by curiosity and perhaps a bit of allure of free stuff, started responding to offers from online retailers. Companies would offer full refunds for purchases, just asking for a review, and sometimes not even that. So they got free stuff. This quickly scaled, allowing them to accumulate a large collection of smart home devices, switches, cameras, vacuums, Wi-Fi routers. Once these devices were in the home networks, the real investigation began. Many of the devices from brands like Tekken or Treat Life relied on the Tuya backend system. And Tuya has always known to be problematic. During device registration, Tuya collects an alarming amount of personal and sensitive data, name, phone number, email, your Wi-Fi, SSID. Making matters worse, any Tuya registered developer, which used to be free, now costs around $1,000, could access the entire database of all customers. That means sensitive information like your home plan from your vacuum, whether your lights are switched on and off, whether your door is locked or unlocked, could already be accessible online. Think about that for a moment. A complete stranger, a criminal, someone working for a foreign government, knows whether your home and whether your door is locked. Making matters yet worse, Tuya can at any time push firmware updates to your devices without your knowledge. And that's exactly what they did, as the researchers found out. Starting with the cameras that revealed critical flaws. Many of the cameras use an unencrypted peer-to-peer protocol. What that means is that your camera establishes a connection to some relay server somewhere in the world and sends your information unencrypted to that server and then onwards to wherever it has to go. Your camera could also become one of those forwarding stations by just connecting it with an open port to the internet, in which case you become a super node and you start relaying the unencrypted traffic of other people. So you can start looking at other people's camera feeds, all unencrypted. At the beginning of the test, the researchers could still switch off this feature through device configuration. But during the testing, a silent firmware update took away that option. So today, that feature is on by default and you can't switch it off anymore. Someone in China apparently really wants your information to leak unencrypted. Staying with the cameras for a moment, if you know their unique ID, which you can often guess, you can connect to someone else's camera directly, and there's no authentication. So even those cameras that don't leak information unencrypted to the internet, you can just connect to those cameras and have direct access to the video feed. You or someone in China. The researchers found yet more vulnerabilities in their cameras. For instance, one of the stream encoding binaries had such a bad bug that they can open a root shell, basically remotely taking control of the entire camera and adding it to a botnet, using it for any other malicious access to the network or to other networks from your house. Next, the researchers looked at Wi-Fi routers. One router had no web interface whatsoever. Instead, you had to use a mobile app, which just used the device's serial number, again, easily guessable, and that was basically a clear text password for remote access to the router. Again, people with that knowledge can access that free router. Interestingly, that same configuration app connected to Facebook for some reason and to some random IP address in China, letting them know your router is online now. Diving deeper into the router firmware, they even found some code similar to a known router backdoor. Looks like you're after all paying for those free devices. Not with your money, but with your data, and by giving access to your network to a foreign actor. So that's cameras and Wi-Fi routers. But the researchers also found strange behavior in many other places. For example, baby monitors were found to create unauthenticated Wi-Fi access points, essentially opening a direct window into that private space without the user's knowledge. Strangest of all, met one of the researchers. He investigated his adjustable bed that he had explicitly ordered without any Wi-Fi capability. And yet, he found strange SSIDs popping up in his house, and he investigated for quite some time until he found that the bed, in fact, did allow clandestine access to it, and with just one command, someone could have folded him in half. The implications of this research are clear. The free or cheap gadgets are potential spies that give someone in China access to large amounts of data and massive networking resources in Western countries. How do we protect ourselves now? Don't accept free devices into your home. That goes without saying. But what about risks originating from all the devices we already have, which might also be backdoored for all we know? Four ways to add security. First, assume compromise and restrict access. Consider placing all your smart home devices onto a separate network segment or VLAN, and then cut that VLAN either off from the internet or at the very least use a DHCP allocation that doesn't announce a default gateway, so the devices won't automatically connect to the internet. Second, consider flashing an open firmware onto devices. If your device is built on a common microcontroller, there's a good chance that an open option already exists without any backdoors. Look for open source projects like OpenIPC, for instance. These can be flashed without any soldering, giving you full control over the device and removing any untrusted software. Third, scrutinize reviews. These Chinese-built subsidized devices also carry a lot of online hype, so be careful if there are too many five-star reviews with lots of explanation points or just text unrelated to the product description. Careful. And fourth, especially if you're a security researcher, test those devices, first in isolation and then slowly give them more and more access to the internet so that you understand the implications, first of all, what connectivity it requires and which systems it communicates with. Because ultimately, the goal of whoever's behind these botnets might be to borrow your internet access for whatever hacking they want to do in the future, DDoS, intrusions, data leaks, right? So careful, monitor these devices and report any findings back to the community. That's how we all learn together. The story of smart home spies reminds us that cyber isn't just about corporations and nation state. It's about our personal spaces too. Understanding the hidden risk is our first line of defense. When it comes to free devices, always remember, if it seems too good to be true, it probably is. Thanks again to Adam and Matt for their amazing research. If this deep dive into their work opened your eyes, please show it with a like and subscribe. Thanks again for watching Hacking Matters. Stay safe and happy hacking.